sung in proper from there, every home in the country, all were tuned by Pankaj Malik himself.
Prema Pankaj Malik stands out as a titan in his own right. Self-confidence to strike out on his own path. Originality is a hallmark of genius and shines luminously both in the singing and compositions of Pankaj Malik. Human being, warm and compassionate.
আমি যেদিন প্রথম এখানে এলাম সেটা 1939 সাল নভেম্বরের মাঝামাঝি, তারিখটা আমার মনে নেই। এই ঘরেতে প্রথম যেদিন পা দিলাম সেই দিন, তখন আমার বয়স ছিল 17। এসে দেখলাম পরিচয় করে দিলেন জল বড়াল, মানে রায়চাঁদ বড়ালের দাদা। বললেন, পঙ্কজ, এই মেয়েটিকে এনেছি। বলে, বাহ, ভারী সুন্দর তো। আমি প্রণাম করলাম। বলে, আচ্ছা, তুমি গান করতে পারো? আমি অল্প অল্প পারি। খুব ভালো, বস। বসলাম, দেখিনি তো ওই পঙ্কজবাবু যার নামেতে আমরা পাগল, তার রেকর্ড শুনতাম, পাগল হয়ে গেছিলাম। আমরা সবসময় গাইতাম ওই গানটা, হে নটরাজ জটার বন্ধন করল ফুলে প্রলয় নট। সেই লোককে আমি সামনে দেখছি, কি সুন্দর, কি বিরাট চেহারা, লম্বা সুন্দর হাসি। কখন আমি পঙ্কজবাবুকে দাঁড়িয়ে দেখিনি।
আমি দুষ্ট হয়ে গেছি না কাকাবাবু, আর দুষ্টি করবো না। কাকাবাবু ছুটটা শোনো না।
আমরা যখন একটা ছবি করেছিলাম খুব কষ্ট করে, নিজেরা টাকা টাকা জোগাড় করে, ওকে মৃদিদা একটা করলাম, রেট ঠিক হয়ে গেল, 1000 টাকা অ্যাডভান্স দিলাম। তারপর বললাম যে 2000 টাকা মৃদির থেকে দেবো, আরো 2000 টাকা ওর 2000 টাকা এই পাবো দেবো। উনি মৃদির থেকে দিন এসে বললেন, মৃদিকে চেক করলেন, দুর্গা তোর টাকা দিতে গেছি। বলে, আই কেম টু নো ফ্রম কোচিং অর এইটার যে ইউর স্টিল প্রডিউসিং দিস পিকচার। হ্যাঁ, কোথা থেকে টাকা পাই না, বাড়িও কিনতে পারি, আরো এরকম ভাবে বাড়ি টাড়ি বাগানো দিয়ে দিয়ে আমি যা বুঝেছি সব। ওই তুই আমার 2000 টাকা দিতে ও দিতে হবে না, মানি ব্যাগ খুললেন 1000 টাকা ফেরত দিয়ে দিলেন। এবং সেই দিদার টেক ওয়ান পার্ট চেষ্টা রিহার্সাল ওর বাড়িতে করাতেন এবং সমস্ত টিফিন খরচ উনি দিতেন। তাহলে আবার মিস করতে উঠ থাকবে। ইউ আর সো গ্রেট গ্রেট ম্যান।
I think sometimes in 1946, I met him in the Methodist studio, and since I loved his music, so we became very friends, though I was much junior to him. Then at the tag end of his life, I asked him whether he can give the music in my film called Loco Papa, 1957 perhaps. And he readily agreed. But I told him there is no song, unfortunately, in this film, only background music. I'd love to do that. And I had watched him in the theaters how religiously and also differently he used to compose background music. You know, go to the subject matter, take the dictation from the subject matter, and how the shots are being taken by the director, how the scenarios are being written. And used to find a certain place where music could fit in. And the result was tremendous. Not only his success, not only in Calcutta, but he crossed the boundaries of Calcutta and became all India popular.
Pankaj Malik had become a singing sensation and an all India star by the time the Second World War broke out. Pankaj Malik ji ko humne suna jab main Punjab mein thi. और पंजाब का जो स्टाइल और अंग वो ही ज्यादा हम जानते थे, वो ही सुनते थे, लेकिन इनका स्टाइल जब सुना तो बहुत अच्छा और सिंपल और पुर असर और एक आवाज में अजीब सा एक वजन, और बहुत ही हम लोगों को अच्छा लगा था, और सिंपलिसिटी गाने में, और बहुत ही प्यारा गाते थे, बहुत अच्छा गाते थे। और उनका मुझे वो गाना याद आ रहा है, जग में से पवन के पवन के It's amazing what you offer me as a singer. Usually makes us overlook the fact that this was the man who pioneered playback singing in India.
He had a very big role to play with the introduction of the playback system in India. Once when Mr. Nitin was coming to this new theatre studio where I have the privilege of sitting even today and giving this interview, he went to fetch Pankaj Malik from his residence. He went up and saw that an English song was being played in a house next door. And Pankaj Malik was quietly humming that tune, giving lip movement to that particular song. The name of this English film was Pagan. And the name of the song I still remember is Come With Me. So that gave Nitin Babu an idea. He came down, he brought Pankaj Malik down to the car. He rushed to the studio. He perhaps stopped somewhere near the Esplanade, bought a copy of that record, came to the studio, played that record. He said, "The Pankaj, when this song is being said, you give the lip movement." And Pankaj Malik at the side started singing the song and began giving the lip movement as a background song to the song. That was the start of the invention of the playback system in India itself.
In as a music director is no less significant. Pankaj Malik had no inhibition about utilizing the resources of the Western musical repertoire to enrich his compositions.
It was not so conservative like other Indian music districts, you know. It was very liberal. So he said that, why should I use only classical music and classical? And music, the seven notes of music, that is universal. So if certain situations requires English notes, I'll do that. Foreign notes, I'll do that. And his association with Western classic was equally good.
He belonged to a generation which tried to integrate popular music with Western music. New theatres had a pioneering role to play in introducing Western-style orchestration into popular music. By Western-style orchestration, I mean that the orchestra is not repeating the melody of the song. The musical interludes are in fact developing the music and expressing it both through harmony and, in the case of the new theatre composition, through counterpoint, through a second melodic line. And in doing this, I think all three greats of new theatres, Pankaj Malik, Timur Baran and Ashi Boral, have a huge role to play.
Despite his creative experimentation, Pankaj Da was deeply rooted in the Indian tradition. He has set some poems of Kalidas to soul-stirring music.
वो संस्कृत में भी बहुत अच्छा गाते थे. उन्होंने कालिदास के कुमार संभव के प्रथम कुछ दोहे हैं. अस्तुत परस्याम दिशिदेवत आत्मा हिमालयो नाम नगासी राजा पूर्वा परो तो ये निजी बगाये स्थितः पृथिव्या इहो बाणगन. उसको भी बहुत अच्छा संगीत पद उन्होंने किया.
यू टेक द फिल्म महाप्रस्थान फॉर द ईयर, यू टेक द टाइटल फिल्म ऑफ द टाइटल सॉन्ग ऑफ महाप्रस्थान फॉर द ईयर, यू सी दैट शास्त्रीय संगीत स्तोत्र व्हेन द फिल्म स्टार्ट इटसेल्फ. If the people from the very tone of the music itself, people think that something good, something godly is coming out of it.
Of the mother goddess Devi in her incarnation as Mahishasur Mardhini was first broadcast in 1932. It became immensely popular and has since been an annual feature of the Navaratri Mahalaya celebration. It commands a large fan in Jumali.
Sarva-sau-bhagya-dai
The bhajan he sang struck just the right note, inviting the devotee to gently keep aside the worldly concerns and enter into a personal communion with the devotee.
Hari Nama Simar, Rama Nama Simar, Shiva Nama Simar, Dinera. Ram Ram Ram
Ram Ram Ram Ram Ram Ram the mood of subdued suffering, a reluctant expression of sweet sorrow engendered by unrequited love. Pining for what is forever lost. Its sensitive handling allowed the words to take wings. They soared ecstatically to the listener's eternal delight.
Go of new theatres which comes at the end of each film where we see the logo of an elephant and you sir and behind and below the these words are written in Sanskrit Jivatam Jyotireku Chayam. Jivatam Jyotireku Chayam means the title song of new theatres was tuned by Pankaj Mallick.
Before him, the Sanskrit doctors, people used to sing still now, in a chanting way, not with tala. It is very difficult to scan the stotras in tala. So, for that reason, he's a pioneer in this field. I am just singing a piece of Sanskrit stotra. I am singing especially Saraswati Vandana because he used to worship Saraswati before anything. Shet Padmasana Devi Shet Pushpop Shobhita and Punjabi kurta, he was indistinguishable from hundreds and thousands of other Bhadralok of his generation. He is lovingly remembered as a caring husband, doting father, and an encouraging mentor.
Amar jokhon biye hoy tokhon amar boyosh 16 bochor, unar 26 bochor. Uni radio te sangeet shikha shuru korten, amra choto belay shuntam, tokhon amar biye shondho hoyni. বিয়ের সম্বন্ধ হয়নি, পরে আমার বিয়ের সম্বন্ধ হলো। আর স্টুডিওতে বিএম সরকারি স্টুডিওতে উনি কাজ করতেন, আর রেডিওতে সঙ্গীত শিক্ষা আসর করতেন, সকলকে দেখাশোনা করতেন, সংসারও করতেন, আবার গান বাজনাও করতেন, আর খুব আনন্দে থাকতেন। पंकज मल्लिक साहब के गाने जो हमारे कलकत्ता में जो बहुत ही मशहूर हुआ करते हैं, जैसे कि एक प्रोग्राम आता है महिषासुर मर्दिनी, जो महालय मॉर्निंग पे वो बजती है रेडियो पे, वो तो हम बचपन से सुनते आ रहे हैं एवरी ईयर। और फिर जो उनके बहुत ही पॉपुलर गाने हैं उनसे भी मैं बहुत अच्छे से वाकिफ थी। अब जब ऐसा हुआ कि शादी के दौरान ऐसे बातचीत हो रही थी कि इस फैमिली में है एक ग्रैंडसन उनका, उनसे शादी की बात, तो वी वर ऑल्सो वेरी थ्रिल्ड कि एक कल्चर्ड ऐसी फैमिली में जाएंगे, बिलोंग करेंगे वहाँ पे। और जैसे हुआ शादी के बाद उनके बारे में और भी जानकारी मिलने लगी। पंकज मल्लिक के जमाने में काफी बाइलिंगुअल मूवीज बनती थी, तो उन दिनों जब बंगाली एक वर्षन होता था और हिंदी दूसरा वर्षन होता था, हमको ये देखने को मिला कि काफी हद तक उन्होंने एक सिचुएशन में जो बंगला गाना कंपोज किया, हिंदी वर्षन में कुछ अलग ही कंपोजिशन हमको कभी कभी देखने को मिलती है। तो ऐसा एक एग्जांपल जैसे कि आपको बता सकते हैं कि बंगाली एक बहुत फेमस मूवी हुई थी डॉक्टर, जिसकी हिंदी वर्षन थी डॉक्टर। और वही सिचुएशन जब हिंदी में हुआ तो उन्होंने कंपोज किया। We first met Dada in September 1957. I remember it very, very well because we were coming from Delhi and he was coming from Calcutta, and we met on the airport like small babies. We were so happy to see him. He was our ideal and idol. And then, you know, the relationship, not only as a teacher and a student, but also as a father and children. Dada was extremely loving. He was a wonderful father. He was also a wonderful gentleman. He was a thorough gentleman. Calcutta, the city he grew up in, remained home to him throughout his life. Others may have been tempted by the lure of money or glitter of Bombay, when the luster of new theatres seemed to fade. Pankaj Mallick remained loyal to Calcutta, and the denizens of this great city continued to shower their affection on him. His memory has consecrated the places where he lived and worked.
There have been many music directors from Calcutta who migrated to Bombay for obvious reasons. Pankaj Mallick had many such offers, but he never went. He sat in Calcutta in the same music department. He said, if somebody has to record my music, he has to come all the way from Bombay and do it. And the producers in Bombay said that. When the new theatres went into rather financial difficulties, my father once called Pankaj Mallick in the studio itself and said, Pankaj, You see, I'm in hard days. I cannot afford your salary. Everybody is going to Bombay. Why are you not following suit? He said, sir, this is the place where you have given me my bread and butter. This is the soil from where I have become Pankaj Mallick as a music director, as an artist, or as a composer, or whatever it is. And just because new theatre is in bad taste, you think that I will migrate to Bombay. And that, on that occasion, there were tears both in my father's eyes as well as in Pankaj Mallick's eyes.
The singer was showered with awards and acclaim throughout his life. The Padma Shri was bestowed upon him in 1970. And he was the first recipient of the Dada Saheb Phalke Award from the realm of film music. Now the renown and recognition were well deserved for a lifetime devoted to music. Almost all his songs are all timeless classics that have retained their appeal across 75 years. What Pankaj Babu valued above all was the love and adoration he received from his beloved listeners. His music recognized no barriers of caste, creed, or even language.
पंकज मलिक दी पंकज मलिक। अभी उनकी आवाज के बारे में कुछ कहने की जरूरत ही नहीं है क्योंकि पंकज मलिक की आवाज ही उनका पहचान है जो एक आधार में आनंददायक है और साथ में गंभीर और बुलंद है। इतनी बुलंद आवाज मेरे ख्याल से संगीत जगत में और किसी की हुई नहीं है।
पंकज मलिक साहब ने संगीत की दुनिया में खासतौर से फिल्म का जो संगीत है इस संगीत की दुनिया में उन्होंने नई नई तरह की नई नई इजादें की जैसा कि मैं अर्ज करूँ कि काउंटर मेलोडी हारमोनी और इसका इस्तेमाल पंकज साहब ने किया। पंकज मलिक साहब ने किया डबल बेस भी सबसे पहले पंकज मलिक साहब ने फिल्मों में तारुफ उसका कराया और इंग्लिश फ्लूट
a little over a quarter century when Pankaj Malik bid adieu to his fans. But the passage of time has not dimmed his memory.
Unki janm shatabdi ke avsar par Sehgal ki shayad pichle saal ya do saal ho gaye janm shatabdi aur Pankaj Malik ki is saal hai unhone shraddhanjali arpit karta hu aur kritajnata arpit karta hu hum hamari peedhi ke aajkal ke logon ka bhi naam bhi nahi unka suna durbhagya hai maine bahut sare logon ko pucha हमने कभी नाम नहीं सुना उनका संगीत सुनना तो करते ना इसको मैं चाहूंगा कि उनकी जो अमर गीत है वो किसी तरीके से फिर से लोगों के सामने आए और लोग स्वयं मूल्यांकन करें कि उस समय का संगीत अच्छा था कि आज जो संगीत सुनने मिल रहा है कुछ
बिल्डिंग विच यू आर लुकिंग हियर दिस इज द हाउस वेयर पंकज मलिक वाज कंपोजिंग फेमस सॉन्ग एंड डिफरेंट म्यूजिक The great song, Kadam Kadam Baraye Ja. The music was composed from here. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Raj Kapoor, these famous eminent persons, they came here and made different music composed with the help of great Pankaj Mallik. This is 12th and Shell Lane. That is why we are trying our best to keep this building as heritage.
Carry his legacy forward, we, on behalf of the family and his fans, have launched a Pankaj Mallik Music and Art Foundation. Jo main kaam kiya jata hai isme, it's basically to archive all his works. Tentatively speaking, there are about 5,000 compositions of his, of which only about 700 probably have been published. Lekin jo baki hai, we are trying to figure them out. Kahan pe kya hai, we are trying to get them and get them into the best condition possible so that we can keep it for posterity, so that the people of the current generation can get to know about this legendary musician.
I've never heard any stories that the ghost of Pankaj Mallik still haunts the corridors of Akashwani Kendra, Calcutta. But if anybody whispers it in my ears, I'd be half inclined to believe it. Pankaj Mallik had an incredibly long tenure as a musician with All India Radio in Calcutta, more than 50 years. And it was a great honor for us to put together some of his best recordings from our archives on Rabindra Sangeet and to release it earlier in this year. It was a tremendous honor for us in Calcutta to have the cream of the Bengali music loving circles present in the auditorium to be able to see the CD being released. And it was a tremendous honor for us, thirdly, in Prasar Bharati to have almost all the stocks sold out within 1 week. So it was one of our great best-selling CDs. I'll just hold it up for you. If you can have a look at it, there is Mr. Mallik looking, I'm afraid, rather professorial and grim in that photograph. But that was the style. people like to look professional, they like to look serious musicians, and his very clothes reflect Pankaj Malik's nationalist feelings. He doesn't come across as a Bengali singer. He's trying to project a more national level image. And it's well for us to remember this was a generation which was thoroughly committed to nationalist ideals.
His sonorous songs continue to regale us, transporting us to that ethereal realm where time stands still and the artist is immortal.
Guzar gaya wo zamana kaisa kaisa guzar gaya tumna tamanna ho kuch ne kadam kadam par
Once you have that theater, it's possible.